Alright guys, so for today's video, I'm going to go over an issue that I've had for quite a while, but it became so bad that the vehicle was pretty much undrivable. And the issue had to do with the four-wheel drive. So basically, for the last probably year and a half, what it was doing was sometimes I would get in the car and it would be in a different position for the transfer case. So it would be in four low, four high, sometimes auto. It just varied. So I didn't really pay too much attention to it. I would just change it back and everything was good. But it progressively got to the point where sometimes I would start the car, it would stay in too high, but there'd be no lights. And that was still fine because it was in too high. So I still let it go and I still didn't let it bother me. I started doing a little research and I did find that like some people just threw parts at it. And that's one thing I didn't want to do, was throw a bunch of parts at it. So one day, actually a couple of days ago, I get in the car and I have no lights and the car is in four low. You can feel it. I mean, it's the it has the transmission where it won't shift as high, or it won't shift at certain points. You can tell the front axle's activated, and it was just a pain in the ass. So the first thing I did was I tried resetting the battery. Or resetting the car pretty much. So I unplugged the battery and I let it sit there probably 10 minutes, drained it out, and then put it back on, came back in, still no lights. So from there, I knew I was gonna have to pull the code. So I pulled the code and it came up with the TCCM, so the transfer case control module. But there was also other things that it could be. So doing a lot of research, a lot of people said it could be the switch. So I went and I found a backup switch, used one that was working, because I didn't want to pay $100 from the auto store just to see if it would fix the problem, and it wouldn't have. So I swapped it out and I had the same issues, no lights. So from there, the next thing to do would be to see if there was communication in between here to the TCCM. So what I did was, if you go under the hood, which I'm about to show you right now. So when you go under the hood and you open the engine compartment fuse box, you'll look for something like transfer case control, four-wheel drive, and you won't find it under here. That fuse is actually inside in the interior fuse box for the four-wheel drive. But what you will have is the one that says Trek. And what you'll do is you'll start the car, you won't press any buttons. And typically if you remove Trek, it'll automatically shut everything off and put it back in two-wheel drive, because it basically disengages transfer case and everything. So I did that, I pulled the fuse, and nothing happened. So basically after I tried the fuse situation, I knew that there was basically no communication to the TCCM. So the module, there had to be an issue with the module. I already swapped out the switch with the used one that worked. That didn't fix it. I tried pulling the fuse and it wouldn't reset. So my next step was to buy a transfer case control module. So these things aren't very cheap. They're about $220. And then they have a $200 core because a lot of the companies rebuild them. Typically you won't get a new one, you'll get a refurbished one. So that's what I did. I went to O'Reilly's and I took the one out of here and I went and bought the one from O'Reilly's and just turned it in the same time I bought the refurbished one. So that way I'd have to pay the $200 core. And one important step that a lot of people don't tell you is that when you put it in, there's a certain way you gotta plug it in. So one of the plugs will go on last and you have to disconnect the battery. So when you put the new transfer case control module in, you have to disconnect the battery before you start. And then you're still gonna plug it in a certain order. So there's a four pin, I believe it's four pin plug, and that's the last. After this, you're gonna wanna let the car sit and make sure that everything drains out of it. So basically when you plug the battery back in, it's gonna reset everything. What I did was I disconnected the battery, I put the transfer case control module in, and then I automatically put the battery back on together. I started up and I had the same issue, no lights. So I was pissed. I'm like, man, I just dropped $200. I followed the steps, I got the code read, and I was really irritated. So what happened was I just disconnected the battery and I walked away. I was frustrated, but that was the best thing I could do, was walk away, because I was tired. I didn't want to end up being like the people on the forums, and just throwing money at a brand new switch, throwing money at the TCCM, throwing money at the transfer case shift motor. So I let it sit for a while, and then I read one thing on a forum that said to actually let the car sit for a couple hours, and then once you put it back together, everything will work normal. So that's what I did. I let it sit for probably about 5 or 6 hours, and then I came back out, connected the battery back up, started it, everything worked perfect. So I'm going on day 2 or day 3 right now, and everything's been perfect. And this is a refurbished product that's in here, the transfer case control module. So as time goes on, I'll see if they hold up or if that was the total issue. But doing that, replacing that and resetting everything, everything works normal again. So if you guys have any questions on this issue or any concerns, just let me know and I'll help you as much as I can. Because like I said, this is a frustrating thing to go wrong on your truck. The initial issues of just having, you start it up and it's in four-wheel drive is one thing, but when it makes it to where you can't drive your vehicle home or to work, it's very frustrating. So if there's any questions, like I said, feel free to drop them and I'll help you out as best I can. And if you got anything else, if this helped you, let me know.